Anyway, we'll start with trapezoid. The area of trapezoid is half the height times the length of the bases. So just refresh our memory with the trapezoid. We have two bases, and the bases are parallel to each other. You have a height, which is perpendicular to both bases. The height is the same no matter where you draw it. So if I drew it over here, it would be the same height as it was over here. Then you have your two legs. Okay, sometimes those are equal, but I felt like they're not. It's just a regular trapezoid. Okay. So my formula is half the height times the sum of the bases. Some people prefer the height times the sum of the bases divided by 2. Okay? Alright? So, same formula, just some people don't like the fraction in front. They don't like the fraction as a big fraction. Alright, so. First couple of examples. What's the height of this first one?
30.
So you take 30 times the sum of the bases. My bases are 28 and 58. So you would add those together, divided by 2. So I just want to say if I take half 30, that's 15. And then the sum of my bases would be 86. Okay? So you have 15 times 86, which is 1290. My answer is 1290 centimeters squared. Now remember yesterday when I told you to take half one of the factors, or half the other, or half the product, you would not be able to take half of the bases until you added this together. Okay? So be careful with that. Alright. Sometimes you have to search for pieces that you need, okay? Because if you look at this, well, first of all, it's rotated, okay? I know this base, right? What else do I know? I know the height, which is 6, but I don't know this length, right? Okay, and I know this length, but that base right now. So, what you have to do sometimes is break it up. Make this into a rectangle and a triangle, okay? And that will help you figure out what this other base is, okay? So if this is a rectangle, this is 6, so then this becomes 6. It's off the side becomes 6. And so now I have a what kind of triangle right here? I have a right triangle, okay? And so I can figure out what this length is, which will then help me find this bottom part, which is the same as the other base. So what would I do to figure out that link right here? With the fact that you're pretty
recognized. No.
Not 2. 3, 4, 5. So what's the multiplier?
4.
The answer is 8. Multiplier with 2. 3 times 2, 4 times 2, 5 times 2. But, like my other hours, so you don't recognize it. So we would do 6 squared plus 8x squared equals 10 squared. And definitely don't use the wrong term. Okay? So we get 36 plus x squared equals 100. X squared equals 4. And so this little piece here is 8. And so since this whole thing is 13, what does it make this bottom part?
5.
Which means this over here is 5. So now, I can find area, okay? So what's my height?
6.
Okay, the sum of my bases, or what are my bases? 13 and 5, then divided by 2. So that ends up being 3, and 13 plus 5 is 18. 18 times 3 is 4 inches. Alright, questions open. Okay, so that's a trapezoid. Now we want to talk about height and rhombus. Okay, and they have the same formula. Well, first of all, a rhombus technically is a parallelogram, so you could use base times height, but if they don't give you that, this is another option for you. But it's half diagonal 1 times diagonal 2, and it's the whole diagonal. Okay. Some people prefer to write it diagonal 1 and measuring times diagonal 2 divided by 2. Okay. Alright. get together. The height has its own special thing. All right. So this first one is a glottis. Now, they are giving us only part of this diagonal. So the vertex to the center is 10 feet, so that makes a whole diagonal left. And then this whole diagonal will be 24. And so if I plug that into my formula, diagonal 11 times diagonal 2 divided by 2, that would be what? 40. See, half of 20 is 10, 10 times 24 is 40, so there's a little math for it. Okay? I still want to know how you solve the problem. Alright? Okay, here's another one. This time it is a kite, same formula. Diagonal 1 times diagonal 2 divided by 2 plus diagonal 1 is 6 times diagonal 2, which is 15, divided by 2. That's 6 is 3 times 15, which is 45 meters squared. Now, these problems were relatively easy. Beware. You could possibly have to use the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, you could possibly have to use the 30, 69, 45, 45, 90 sine, cosine, tangent. Okay, none of that stuff's off limits. Okay, I just wanted to basically show you what the formula was. Okay, here's one where they put it on the coordinate plane. I went ahead and graphed it for you. And this one's pretty easy because the links that I need are horizontal and vertical. Okay? If the links were not horizontal and vertical, what would I have to use to find links? The distance formula. Okay? But since these faces are horizontal and my height is vertical, I can just count the faces. Okay? So EF is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. HG is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then my height is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So what was the formula for a trapezoid? So base, the base is added together and then divided by 2. Okay, so what's my height? 5. What's the sum of my bases? 17 divided by 2. That's shortcuts of that one. Those are odds. 17 times 5. A fraction that number over 11. operator times 9. Two choices. I either multiply both sides by 2, or I can divide 2 into 10.
Or 2 into 10.
By 2 into 10. So that gives me 250 equals 5 times 6 plus 30. So then we have to distribute. And subtract 150 from both sides, which gives me 100, equals 5x. Divide those sides by 5.